Hello everybody and welcome to the Application Laboratories at Mettler Toledo. My name is Lukas Fritsche and I'm Applications Chemist for Titration. Today I'm going to show you how to determine the water content in samples that contain ketones and aldehydes, such as for example acetone. We will do this on an EVA volumetric Carl Fischer titrator. Samples that contain ketones and aldehydes undergo side reactions with alcohols that are mostly used as the solvent for Carl Fischer titration. These side reactions produce water and lead to a high chemical drift or can even bias the result. To suppress these side reactions, most suppliers have developed special reagents that are not based on alcohols and which suppress the side reactions. Usually, these special reagents are labeled with a K in the name, and we recommend to use those special reagents to perform Carl Fischer determinations with samples that contain ketones and aldehydes. To determine the water content of our sample, we first need to create a method on our instrument. This is very easy, and I show you how to do it on an EVA titrate. First, go to the menu, and we find the methods and the normal volumetric Carl Fischer methods in a list. Now our list is empty because we haven't created a method yet. To create a new method, just click on New. All the methods are based on templates. Under specific templates, we find a dedicated template for ketones and aldehydes, which we're going to use. If we open the template, all the parameters are pre-adjusted and the method will be ready to use. So we just create the method based on this information. The only thing that we're going to change is the number of samples that we are determining for this demonstration. We're only going to determine one sample. Upon saving, we create a method. And to make it even easier, we create a shortcut such that we can start the method from the home menu. We give a name to the shortcut, for example, acetone. And we allow an immediate start of the method. Let's create the shortcut and go to the home menu. Now we can find the shortcut and start the method with one click. Now, the first thing that the titrator has to do when we start the method is making sure that the titration cell is water-free. To do this, we first do a so-called conditioning. In the conditioning, we check that the drift value, which shows how much water is getting into the cell per amount of time, is as low and stable as possible. If the titrator finds that the drift is low and stable enough, we can start the sample, which is the case now because the Start Sample button is in lighted green. We will now prepare the sample. We will determine the sample by manual injection via a syringe. To do this, I take a little bit of the sample. And I wash my syringe with the sample. The sample that I used for washing can be discarded. And now we fill the syringe with as much sample as we need for a whole series of determinations. We make sure that there's no droplet on the outer side of the needle, and it's better to remove any air in the headspace of the syringe. Now we can place the needle on the balance and set the balance to zero. After we have zeroed the balance, we check if the drift condition is still fulfilled, which is the case, and we can start the sample. From now on, the titrator will detect any water that we inject, and it will start the titration as soon as we have injected the sample. We get our syringe and inject an appropriate amount of the sample. Make sure to pull the plunger back a little bit to avoid a droplet at the end of the needle. We put the syringe back on the balance. And because the balance is connected to the titrator, the weight is transferred automatically, and we can just accept the weight as soon as the balance is ready. In the background, the titrator has already started the titration because it only needs the sample size at the end for the calculation of the water content. Now the sample is being titrated, and we can see the drift approaching back to zero and the measured value approaching 30 microamperes, which is the end point of our titration. And we have our result. By the way, the method that we are using relies on so-called drift stability parameters for the start and the termination of the drift. This means that rather than checking for absolute drift values, we're checking for a stability of the drift, which allows us to titrate even at elevated drift, for example, in cases where we are not allowed or we cannot use special reagents and we have a high chemical drift. The drift stability parameters are unique for EVA titrators and allow us to titrate even at elevated drifts. For more information, please check out our application note about water content determinations in ketones and aldehydes on our website.